everyone, and welcome back to my channel! Well guys, today we're going to repaint another Monster High doll, and this time I thought we would make another character from one of my most favorite animated movies ever, from the Inside Out by Disney Pixar. And you know, a couple of years ago I've made already a Sadness doll. It was a tiny doll, I made her out of an LOL doll, and she was so adorable. I loved my mini Sadness that much that I even kept her for myself. I never sold her. She's standing there with other LOL dolls. Wait, where is my sad? She fell down! She fell down, you see? You see, this is what always happens to Sadness. All other dolls are just standing there nicely displayed, everybody can see them, and Mini Sadness is just laying somewhere alone in the darkness. Yeah, this is it. This is it. I'm kidding, of course, but I really love this character. This is my favorite character in the cartoon, and I really love this doll. So I thought we should continue a little bit working on these characters from the movie, and today I want to make a Disgust doll. And you know, I feel that this character, the Disgust, that she's a little bit kinda underdeveloped in the movie. Well, let's be honest, there are just two very well-developed characters. There is Joy, this very annoying, like the embodiment of toxic positivity, and there is this beautiful, sad Sadness. And all the other characters, they are not that important. I have even rewatched the movie last night. I wanted a little bit to refresh all the details, to find more reference like for my doll. But actually there is not that much to work on. There is not so much to borrow from the cartoon. Because yes, we know how she looks, we know her attitude, but that's it. There are not that many funny episodes with her, unfortunately. Because I think that in the future movie, in the Inside Out 2, normally they are working on it now, I think that Disgust is going to play much bigger role. Because you know, the first episode of the movie came out in 2015, and it means that they developed characters and worked on it even earlier. And then yes, probably our society was kind of less toxic or something, because right now I would say that probably 50% of the population have been ruled just by the emotion of Disgust alone. Like, there are so many toxic people, and these toxic reactions, they're just all over the place. I don't know, or our life have become a little bit more stressy, and that's why we're reacting like this. You know, Disgust supposed to protect us from poisoning, and as well as, you know, it's not just food poisoning, but poisoning by some other things. So maybe that's why we have so much Disgust, this emotion of Disgust in our life nowadays, because there are too much poison around to protect us from it. But anyway, it doesn't matter, we will see what they will do with her in the second episode. But I don't know, my prediction is that Disgust is gonna be one of the main characters there. Well, and for me it would be very interesting today to try to develop this character a little bit more, try to keep her 100% recognizable, but at the same time, like, my version of this Disgust girl. Well, yeah, and this is it probably. Let's start working. There are lots of ideas in my head, so I want to start working on it already. And of course, guys, like always, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button, and of course support my art here on YouTube with your likes, because this is something that really helps me to develop further my art and my channel and my presence here on YouTube. So thank you so much for your support, and now let's start working. So here is our model for this makeover, and I think she will be just perfect for this Disgust makeover, because she has already this round face and nose, kind of all these face shapes are more or less similar to the movie character, and plus she has already a green skin tone, so she is perfect. So now let's undress her, cut her hair off, and then we'll disconnect the head from the body after warming it up with a hair dryer for a couple of minutes. Thank you. Okay, now let's pull out all the hairs that is still sitting inside of the head, and after this we will remove her face with pure acetone. So after this I'm spraying the face with a couple of layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant, and then we can actually start drawing the face. I don't want to make her too cartoonish, I want to make her look, I don't know, like rather like some arrogant and sarcastic young lady, like one of those beauties who think that they're a little bit better than the rest of the people. So I start with sketching her eyes with watercolor pencils, and then I work on her skin tone using green and white soft pastels. The sealant that I'm using has made the doll's face matte, and it's also quite close to paper texture now, so I can draw everything like regularly, like I would normally do on paper, and I also use the Mr. Super Clear sealant between the layers to save my progress. And I think I use at least, I don't know, 20 to 25, I would say, light layers of the sealant on the face to reach the result that I can call finished. And also talking about time, I usually calculate 3 to 4 days for a face and a body in my weekly planning, just to give you an idea a little bit about how long it all takes. So, Disgust has everything green on her face, the eyes, the eyeshadows, the eyebrows, just the lips are bright pink, almost Barbie pink color, the same like the shoes, and also like the scarf on her neck. So, this is what I'm drawing now. She also has pink blush on her cheeks, and of course it would be much easier to make it in a CGI animation rather than in real life, because this pink is gonna mix with the green skin tone, and I can tell you honestly, it will be dirty purple mess of the year on her face. But I still want to give her that blush, that's why I will try to pack it kinda with a quite thick layer just on the apples on her cheeks, like not really blending it around, trying to cover up the green color completely, and I will have to repeat this step a couple of times on a couple of layers to reach the acceptable result until this green is completely covered with the pink. Well, this is it. Now let's sand her body with nail buffers, and then we'll seal it with Mr. Super Clear sealant. These steps will make the body super matte, and we will be able to blush it with green soft pastels and with white ones, the same like we just did to her face. Honestly, it's not my favorite step because it's quite, I don't know, technical, repetitive. There is close to zero creativity in it, but it's a necessary one, so let's do it quickly and move on to her hair. I've bought these two types of green acrylic yarn. The colors are slightly different. I don't know if you can see it on camera, but one is a little bit darker and one is a little bit brighter. So I thought I would mix them together to make your hair color more alive and interesting, kind of less flat green. So and now we're going to turn this yarn into hair, and for this I'm first cutting it into short pieces. Then I'm tying this yarn around barbecue sticks, and this is when I'm connecting the lighter and the darker green colors together. After this, I'm making the yarn loose. Brushing it with a cat brush. And then I make it straight with a hot hair straightener. As a result, check it out, we get perfect and shining green hair, and I think you can kind of see the highlights a little bit in her hair, so it looks absolutely perfect. So now let's take white tacky glue and attach it all to the hat. I have decided to use yarn hair today instead of rerouting her with some nylon hair, for example, because this doll will have a shorter hairstyle, and styling rerouted short hair is a real hell on wheels, really, I hate it. Nylon hair would anyway always try to jump up unless you use really a ton of styling products on it, like, you know, some Monster High dolls, they have bangs that feel really crunchy from hairspray, it feels really glued, and I'm not really a fan of it. I prefer making short hairstyles and bangs on very light and fine yarn hair, because it's very, very easy to style, and in the end it would look very natural. Okay, check it out, it's all dry, it looks already very cute, so now I want to cut and style her hair. And first of all, I will chop it with scissors, a little bit longer than it's supposed to be. And then I will use an eyebrow razor to make it all look pretty, kind of to make the ends thinner, to make it all lay pretty. So this is where I've ended up so far, and you know I really love it already, we could keep it already like this. But anyway, I always do this last step with wrapping her head with a piece of kitchen plastic and keep it in there overnight, because it really makes hair more flat and everything looks more finished, kinda. So the next day I can remove this plastic, and now let's check it out what it's made. Yes, I think you can see the difference quite immediately. Now we can still trim it a little bit here at the back. But yeah, this is it, I think. And I actually really love her hair today. It all looks super cute on her. You know, I don't really make dolls with short hair that often, so it's always fun. I really love her hairstyle. I really love how it's turned out. So now I think we can start working on her outfit and accessories and all these other small details. And now you can see my mom helping me to recreate the original outfit from the Inside Out movie. It's a green dress with flowers and darker green cropped leggings. She starts with a pair of leggings, and then we will see how she made the dress. And she was busy for a very, very long time looking for a fabric similar to what Disgust has in the movie. It's dark green with some single flowers, really tiny flowers they're supposed to be in real life. But after finding absolutely nothing close to it, my mom ended up painting the flowers herself with acrylics on this green fabric. And as you can see now, it looks really cool and absolutely identical to the pattern on the dress in the movie. Unfortunately, she didn't film the process of painting the flowers because she wasn't sure if it was a good idea, if it was gonna work. It was made really in a moment of despair. But yeah, it looks very good. I really love how this fabric looks in the end. So, and here is the finished outfit. It looks super cute. The dress feels really so solid and well made with all this lining. Really perfect, absolutely. So now we can put the doll on a doll, and then we'll make some accessories for her. Okay, now this outfit still requires a pair of shoes and also a belt with the letter D on it, like a buckle. So let's get out my Warbler thermoplastic out of the box and let's make a doll. I'm starting with the belt since it's quite easy to make, just maybe carving the letter D will be slightly challenging, but if I don't cut myself with an X-Acto knife, it all should be okay normally. So this is what I've made. Let's try it on a dress. Yes, it looks really good on her, so now we can cover it all with acrylics, with glossy varnish, and then I'll make a pair of pink shoes for her. So this is it, the finished belt. It looks exactly like in the movie. And now let's make a pair of shoes. I was first going to make high heels for her, since she's such a, I don't know, fashion queen in her head. But then I thought I would still stick to the original reference, since the rest of her outfit looks pretty exactly the same like in the movie. I didn't really change anything about it. So I will go for pink ballerina shoes with black soles. So and here are the shoes, and they look really super cute on her, and they also look exactly like in the movie. Okay, I think we're done here, and yes, we can make something else for her, something special. So first of all, I wanted to give my disguised girl a newspaper, because there in the film she is reading a newspaper with some sarcastic titles. I don't remember, cannot recall it immediately what was there in this newspaper. So I thought I would make also something like this, a newspaper with some, I don't know, quirky articles in it. Then my creativity started to float, go a little bit farther. And instead of a newspaper, I thought I would make some sort of a magazine, like a Vogue or Cosmopolitan, something like this. But then I started to think even farther, and then I thought, look, actually my favorite part of the movie, of the Inside Out, is where you can see this set of emotions sitting in another person's head. It's very interesting to see, for example, the disgust of Riley's father. It's interesting to see the disgust who is ruling this girl who is selling pizza with broccoli. And so far, like, for example, it was very interesting to see that mom has been ruled by sadness, but with joy at her right hand. So it was really interesting for me to see how these emotions from different people look, because they all look completely different. And like this, I've got kind of an idea of creating a magazine for my doll, because, you know, she's so sassy, she's so stylish. She would probably read some Vogue magazine. And I want to draw like different kinds of emotions, like to let my fantasy a little bit go and think about how disgust of some, for example, royal lady will look, or how a disgust of some celebrity would look. So I thought I would just take an existing drawing of disgust, and I would remake it, redraw it on iPad myself, trying to create my own character. So you will see in a second what I mean. I will now grab my iPad and I will draw all my ideas, trying to create this Disgustopolitan magazine. So first of all, we need a superstar, of course. Somebody super famous, someone who will be on the cover of our magazine. And first of all, I think we will give her some long glittery dress. Really, a lot of shine everywhere, sparkles, glitter. Let's also give her a microphone, because look, her hand has been just made for it. And I also want to give her some super big glamorous hair, because I think she will be some, I don't know, like Latin American telenovela star or something like this. The one that is singing and acting and modeling and just good in everything and absolutely gorgeous. You know, that immortal and legendary type. Okay, let's put some more glitter on the background. Really, everything's supposed to shine here. And now let's give her some name. I don't know, something with disgust in it, but also telenovela sounding. Something like Camila Disgusta or Camila Disgustara. Something like this, sorry. I used to watch a lot of telenovelas as a kid with my grandmother, but it was, of course, 25 years ago. Maybe they don't use these kinds of names anymore. And then remember, there was a moment in the movie when they said that Riley should look really good for her first day at school, and then Disgust replied something like, they will barf and they look at her. So I thought we could use this quote in our interview with our Camila star. Okay, the superstar is finished, and now let's make some royal lady, someone from the royal family with her shocking revelations, because this is what people love reading in magazines like this one. And let's maybe try restyling her original outfit without actually remaking the original shape of it. Let's see how it would change the look. Then I think she needs a hat with a veil to look super royal. And then I want to give her a handbag, because the same like in the case with Camila and her microphone, this girl's hand has been made for a handbag. And then we need some name for her and some shocking details of her life in the palace, of course. Voila, this page is done. I don't know, guys, this episode of the magazine is going to be a super hit on the market. So now let's make something holidays related, like a beach version of Disgust, because going on holidays honestly is the only thing that I really wish right now after sitting in self-isolation since March of 2020. So and while my self-isolation is still continuing, and it will continue approximately till August, I think, I can just dream and draw beach girls. But it's all coming, guys, it's all coming. Let's keep calm and draw beach dolls. This is my way to survive. Thank you. For the background of this page, I want to draw this beach from the tutorial on the Art with Floor channel. I have it in my Watch Later map already for a couple of months, and I just never really had time for it. So why not to do it right now? Because I'm really obsessed with the way the foam looks here on the sand, this white front line. I really want to see how she does it, how she makes it. Want to copy this way of drawing. Really not sponsored, I just really love Flo's channel and her tutorials. So, I don't know, my beach looks finished, I think. I think the water and the foam look pretty good, pretty legit here. It worked. Thank you, Flo, for the tutorial. So, now let's finish the page and then we'll make the cover. And you know, I think I would really call it a Disgustopolitan. It was a working name of the project just in my head, but I don't know, it kind of fits everything that is inside of the magazine and it kind of fits the names and the titles in it. So here it is. I was actually super nervous about printing it, but in reality it looks super cool, really. I've printed it on photo paper, like this it would look shiny and it would also be more, I don't know, kind of sustainable, because just a paper magazine of this format would not survive that long, and this on photo paper normally it would live forever. So and now I can bend the pages and connect them together with a double side tape. And guys, check it out. I don't know, such a tiny thing. I was working on it for 3 days non-stop till 6 in the morning, and as a result I've made something super super tiny. But anyway, it looks very cool, very colorful and very very satisfying. The only problem is that she needs some bag now, so she could put the magazine into the bag when she's not reading it. So we have nothing else to do, we just have to make a bag for her now. Let's make it as well out of Warble thermoplastic, and the bag should be big enough to fit the magazine. So I thought I would try to recreate that iconic shopper bag from Louis Vuitton. What is the name? Neverfull was this big shopper, I think. Because I think my disgust deserves a real designer's bag. So, and this is my doll version of Louis Vuitton Never Full. It looks totally iconic. I hope they won't come for me for copying their designs. So, now let's still attach false lashes because Disgust has very long lashes. Then we'll add glossy varnish to Horizon lips. And after this, we'll finally take a look at the end result pictures. So this is finally my finished Disgust doll, and I honestly think she looks super special because I don't really make these super sassy or arrogant dolls that often, so she feels really unique to me with her attitude kind of written on her face. Her hairstyle is also one love. I should make more dolls with short hair because it's kind of nice break after curling doll hair for hours every week. Her Louis Vuitton bag looks really fun, and I know that some of you probably own this Never Full bag because it's one of the most popular and still more or less affordable models of this brand. So please, the proud owners of this luxury bag, it would be very interesting to hear your opinion about the mini version of the bag. Well, and my personal favorite detail of this project is, of course, the Disgustopolitan magazine. It's maybe a tiny thing, but I really had a lot of fun working on it, and this is actually the first book or magazine I've ever made here on my channel, but it won't be the last one for sure, because it was a really enjoyable process. I really loved making this magazine. So, these are my thoughts about this project. Now I would love, of course, to hear your opinion about it. What do you think about my version of the Disgust character? And also, which emotion do you think is dominating in your personality? I'm normally a mix of joy and sadness, but lately the Disgust has become way louder than it used to be before. I don't know, maybe just aging thing, becoming grumpier while getting older. I don't know, I hope not. So, and now this doll is available for sale on eBay for 3 days. The link to it will be in the description box under this video. And my glow-in-the-dark Octomate is also unfortunately back in stock. The winner of the previous week auction wasn't really serious about buying the doll, so here she is again. And if you're interested in buying one of them, Disgust, Octomate, please check the link in the description box under this video. So guys, and that was it for today. I really hope you've enjoyed this doll makeover video. And if so, please guys, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes. Of course, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button, and I will see you very soon, normally in 2 weeks. Friday. I'm still working on something. I don't think I would be able to finish it just in 7 days. Nope, it's not gonna work. So see you in 2 weeks, guys. Have a nice weekend. Love you. Bye.